Hi, hello, welcome to our channel Kim Sierra. This is Anil. Today we are going to learn about a very important topic, that is Graham's law of diffusion. Before going to learn about Graham's law of diffusion, first let us try to understand about diffusion. What is diffusion? Suppose you have taken a incense stick and light it. After some time, what happened? The entire room get the fragrance of the incense stick. That means the incense stick fragrance has occupied the entire room. This ability of a gas to occupy entire available volume is called as diffusion. I repeat, the ability of a gas to occupy entire available volume is called as a diffusion. Now, the volume occupied by the gas in unit time, is called as a rate of diffusion. This rate of diffusion is indicated by letter R. R is equal to V by T. What is R? R is a rate of diffusion. What is V? V is the volume occupied by the gas. What is T? T is the unit time. Unit time means that may be 1 second, 1 minute, 1 hour, 1 day, whatever it is. It is unit time. According to Graham's law of diffusion, rate of diffusion is inversely proportional to square root of density. Rate of diffusion of gas is inversely proportional to square root of its density. That means here rate of diffusion of the gas and density of gas are inversely proportional to each other. What it indicates? It indicates that if the density of gas is less, its rate of diffusion will be more. When density is more, rate of diffusion will be less. Now, I think all of you know, density is nothing but a ratio of mass to volume. Suppose, let us consider the volume is constant. Then, density and mass are directly proportional to each other. Density and mass are directly proportional to each other. If I substitute molecular mass of gas instead of density, I can rewrite the equation as R proportional to 1 by root m. See, I am giving a simple example. When two persons, one fat and one thin person, are running a race, generally who will win? Generally the person who is thin will win the race. Here also the same. When the gas is having more molecular mass, its density, its rate of diffusion will be less. See, let I just take a simple example. If I have taken two gases, hydrogen and nitrogen, which is going to have more rate of diffusion? Automatically, hydrogen. Why? Hydrogen atomic weight is only 2. Sorry, hydrogen molecular weight is 2. Whereas, nitrogen molecular weight is 28. Whenever molecular mass is more, diffusion is less. Here, for hydrogen, molecular mass is less. That means it is thin. So, its rate of diffusion will be more. Rate of diffusion and molecular mass are inversely proportional to each other. Experimentally, it was observed that molecular mass will be double that of vapor density. What is vapor density that we are going to learn in the higher classes? But let us try to remember its vapor density. What I am saying is, molecular mass of gas will be double that of vapor density. That means molecular mass and vapor density are directly proportional to each other. So I can rewrite the equation as R proportional to 1 by root Vd. What is Vd? V
vapor density. By combining these three equations, I can rewrite the equation as, what is the first equation? R proportional to 1 by root D. What is the second equation? R proportional to 1 by root M. What is the third equation? R proportional to 1 by root VD. When I am comparing for two different gases, having rate of diffusions R1 and R2 respectively, then I can relate the equation as R1 by R2 equal to root of D2 by D1, which is equal to root of M2 by M1, which is equal to root of VD2 by VD1, which is very, 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 very important. Based on this, we are going to solve certain examples. Now, let us consider certain situations where we are going to apply the Graham's law. Now, let us consider two gases having rate of diffusions R1 and R2 respectively. They are allowed to occupy the same volume V. They have taken the time T1 and T2. Then, we can write the equation as R1 by R2 is equal to T2 by T1. Let us consider case 2. Here, we have taken two different gases having a rate of diffusion R1 and R2. At a time T, they are occupying volumes V1 and V2 respectively. Now, we can write the Graham's law as R1 by R2 is equal to V1 by V2. By combining these two equations, I can write the equation as R1 by R2 is equal to V1 by V2 is equal to T2 by T1. This is also very important in case of competitive examinations time. I hope you have liked this video. If you like this video, please give a big thumbs up for me. And if you have any doubts regarding this topic, please mention them in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching.